Hello students, today we solve examples on false position method and Newton's Raphson method. Okay, so first we take example on regular falsi method or a false position method. Okay, example number one. Example is use regula falsi method to find approximate root of equation to find approximate root of equation x cube minus 4x minus 9 is equal to 0. In the interval 2, 3, correct up to 2 decimal places. Correct up to 2 decimal places. Okay. Here we have to give the equation, that is this. We rewrite this equation. F of x is equal to function x cube minus 4x minus 9 is equal to 0. To find the root by using regular falsi method. Okay. We have to give one here also the interval 2 to 3 in which the root is lie. So first by using location of root properties we find the value of f of 2. Here put 2 in this equation we get 2 cube minus 4 into 2 minus 9, and after this calculation we get it's equal to minus 9, which is less than 0. Then similarly we find f of 3 is equal to 3 cube minus 4 into 3 minus 9 is equal to 3 cube is 27 minus 4 into 3 is 12 minus 9, and it's equal to we get 6, which is greater than 0. Okay, here we get f of 2 is less than 0 and f of 3 is, that is 6, which is greater than 0, that is f of 2 into f of 3 will be less than 0. Then by location of root, properties of location of roots, we say root lie between 2 and 3. Here also we have to give an interval, but we find here the values, and by using property we can check the root is lie between 2 and 3. So to find approximate root belongs to 2, 3 in this interval by using regular falsi method, or we name it as also false position method. Okay, take here x0 and x1 be the two initial approximations. x0 will be equal to 2 and x1 is equal to 3. Okay, then also we find the value of f of x0 and f of x1, that is f of x0 is equal to f of 2 is equal to, we find here will be minus 9, and f of x1 is equal to f of 3 is equal to, here we find, which is 6. Then the next approximate root, then the next approximate root by using false position method is we use here formula for this x0 and x1, we get the next approximate root will be x2 is equal to x0 f of x1 minus x1 f of x0 divided by f of x1 minus f of x0. Take this as equation number 1. We have to use this equation for solving the or to find the next approximations. Okay, so we put here these values x0, x1, f of x0, f of x1. X0 will be 2, f of x1 will be into 6 minus x1 will be 3, f of x0 will be minus 9 divided by f of x1 is 6 again and minus of minus 9. We simplify this calculation, we get 6 into 2 is 12, minus minus becomes plus, 9 into 3 is 27 divided by 6 plus 6, this minus minus becomes plus, 6 plus 9 is 15, 6 plus 9 is 15, and if we simplify this calculation we get x2 is equal to 2.6, that is we get x2 is equal to 2.6 be the first approximation. For the first approximate root we get x2 is equal to 2.6 be the first approximate root. Next, to find value of f of x2, that is equal to f of 2.6 is equal to, we have to put 2.6 in given function, that is polynomial function, 2.6 cube minus 4 into 2.6 minus 9, and if we take this calculation we get f of 2.6 is equal to minus 1.824. So see here we get, students, f of x2 is equal to minus value, that is less than 0. We get f of x2 is less than 0, and here f of x1 is, that is here we select, see here we select first interval x0 and x1. We get next approximation in between, this will be x2. Then we have to, we divide this x0, x1 interval to these two sub interval x0, x2 and x2, x1. Then next we have to check either the root will lie between this interval or this interval. So we can find the value of f of x2. We get here f of x2 will be less than 0. Here f of x0 is also less than 0. If we find their product, then we get the product of f of x0, f of x0 into f of x2, we get greater than 0 because both are negative values. If we take the product of f of x1 and f of x, if we take the product of f of x1 and f of x2, then we get here f of x2 will be minus and f of x1 will be positive, that is their product must be less than 0. So we get there is a root lie between, that is root belongs to this interval by using properties of location of roots. If their product is less than 0, then we get the root lie between this interval, that is root belongs to this interval x2 comma x1. So in equation 1 or formula 1, we replace x0 by x0 by x2. We replace x0 by x2, and if we replace x0 by x2, then we get the next approximation. Then we get next approximate root or next approximation, that is x3 is equal to x0 will be replaced by x2. Then x2 f of x1 minus x2 f of sorry x1 f of x2 divided by f of x2 f of x1 minus f of x2. Then we put here the values of x2 f of x1, x1 f of x2. x2 will be 2.6 into f of x1, that is f of 2 will be f of 3 will be 6 minus x1 3 into f of x2, here we find will be minus 1.824 divided by f of x1 6 minus 1.824. And after this calculation, we take this calculation in scientific calc. If we take this calculation, we get x3 will be equal to 2.6932. This is the next approximate root. Okay, here we have to find the approximate root of the equation in interval correct up to 2 decimal places. Okay, correct up to 2 decimal places, that means after decimal points we have to get 2 digits must be same. Here we have to get the after decimal point first 1 digit is same, then therefore we find the next approximation. So again we find the value of f of x3 will be equal to f of 2.6932, that is again we divide this x1 x2 interval, and in between this we get the root, that is again we divide this interval into again sub intervals, that is x3 x2 and x3 x1. So again we have to check either the root lie between this interval x2 x3 or x3 x1. So we find this value. Then if we find the value of f of 2.6932, we get that value is equal to minus 0.2382, which is less than 0. By putting this value in given function, we get this value. So this value will be less than 0. Again, f of x3 is less than 0. So here f of x3 into f of x2 we get less than 0. This implies that root belongs to interval here f of x3 into f of x1 is less than 0, so root belongs to this interval x3 x1. Root belongs to interval x3 x1. So we replace in equation 1 x0 by x3, then we get the next approximate root. Okay, so we get the next approximate root, that is x4 is equal to, if we replace that formula x0 by x3, we get x3 f of x1 minus x1 f of x3 divided by f of x1 minus f of x3 equal to, by putting the values we get x3 will be equal to 2.6932, f of x1 will be into 6 minus x1 is 3, and f of x3 will be defined, that is minus 0.2382 divided by 6 minus 0.2382. It's equal to, after this calculation we get the next approximate root, that is x4 is equal to 2.7140 x4. Again we find the value of f of x4. If we find value of f of x4 by putting this value in given equation, that is 2.7140 cube minus 4 into 2.7140 minus 9, by taking this calculation we get is equal to 0.143, that is we get this value will be greater than 0. Here we get f of x3, x4 is greater than 0, f of x4 greater than 0 and also f of x1 will be greater than f of x1, that is f of 3 will be greater than 0. F of x4 and f of x1 is greater than 0. If we find their product, then we get which is greater than 0. But we have to get their product must be less than 0. So there is a no root lie between this interval. In between x3, x1 we have to get the next approximation, that is x4. Again we find f of x4, f of x1, we get the product will be less greater than 0, that is there is a no root lie between this interval x4, x1. So we check either the root lie between this interval x3, x4. Here f of x3 will be negative and f of x4 will be positive. Then f of x3 into f of x4 we get which is less than 0, that means the next root belongs to this interval x3, x4. Okay, so we can replace, so we replace in equation 1 x0 by, or we name this equation as equation number 2, or then we replace in equation number 2 only this x1 by x4, x1 by x4, then we get next approximate root. Next approximate root, that is we take x5, we get x5 is equal to, we have to replace in this formula x1 by x4. Okay, so x3, f of x4 minus x4 f of x3 divided by f of x4 minus f of x3. Then by putting your values up, we get x3 will be 6932 into f of x4. Here we find f of x4, that is 0.143 minus x4 is 2.7140 into f of x3 is minus 0.2382. We write here minus 0.2382 divided by 0.143 f of x4 minus f of x3 minus 0.2382. And again by taking this calculation in scientific calculus, after this calculation we get is equal to 2.7059. okay, here we observe Here we get x5 is equal to 2.7059. If we observe the root, approximate root x4 and x5, that is these two approximation, if we round up this number x5 to two decimal places, because we have to find the approximate root up to two decimal places. So if we round up this number here up to two decimal places, the second decimal digit is 0 and here third digit is 5, which is third digit is 5, exactly 5. Then by rounding up the number, here 0 will be increased by 1, we get this number will be 2.71. and then we get x4 is will be up to rounding up to two decimal places, we'll get x4 is also 2.71, because here third digit is 4 is less than 5, therefore this 1 will be as it is, and we get x4 will be 2.71. okay, so we get approximate root x5 is equal to 2.71 and approximate root x4 is equal to, that is these two approximation will be same up to two decimal places. So we stop the procedure, and which is the approximate root of the given equation. Here we get two successive approximations, x4 and x5 are same up to two decimal places, therefore we stop procedure and the approximate root of given function of f of x is x is equal to 2.71. this is the approximate root. In this way, okay students, in this way we can find the approximate root by using regular Falsi method. Okay, you see the next example. Example number 2, find a real root, find a real root of the equation, equation is 3x is equal to cos of x plus 1 by Newton's Raphson method. Okay, so we rewrite the equation as f of x is equal to 3x minus cos x minus 1 is equal to 0. To find the root of this equation by using the Newton-Raphson method, that is by NR method, first to find where is a root lie by using properties of location of roots. First to find where root is lie. Okay, so we can consider the two real numbers. So first we consider the number 0 and 1, and we check the value of that value of the function at that point. Here if we find f of 0 is equal to, we get 3 into 0 minus cos 0 minus 1. 3 into 0 will be 0 minus cos 0 will be 1 minus 1 minus 1, then we get is equal to minus 2, which is less than 0. And then we consider the next real number, that is 1. We find f of 1, we get 3 into 1 minus cos 1 minus 1 equal to, by taking this calculation, we get here 3 minus cos 1, we can find in calc 0.5403 minus 1 is equal to, we get 1.4597. See, also here note that value of the angle, that is here we take, we find cos of 1, take the value of the angle in always radian, not in degree. So note that here, note, take value of angle in radian. Okay, then here if we observe, we get f of 0 will be less than 0 and f of 1 will be greater than 0. That is, we get f of 0 into f of 1 is less than 0. This implies that root belongs to 0, 1. Root belongs to this interval 0, 1. So we take first approximate root that is initial approximation that is initial approximation is we consider x0 is equal to, we take 0.6. We can take here x0 is also 0, but here we take x0 is equal to 0.6. We can take any value in between 0 to 1. But the consider initial approximation must be nearest to 0, must be 0 or nearest to 0.0. So we take here x0 is equal to 0.6. Then here f of x will be equal to 3x minus cos x minus 1. By using Newton-Raphson formula, in Newton-Raphson formula we have to use the derivative of that function, therefore we find the f dash of x. Then we get f dash of x is equal to 3, derivative of x will be 1, minus derivative of cos x will be minus sin x minus 0 is equal to 3 plus sin x. This is the f dash of x. Okay, then by using Newton-Raphson formula, here NR formula is, that is Newton-Raphson method formula, xn plus 1 is equal to xn minus f of xn divided by f dash of xn. Okay, then we put here value of the function. Okay, we put here value of the function, we get xn minus f of xn, that is in bracket 3xn minus cos of xn minus 1 divided by f dash of xn will be 3 plus sin xn is equal to, here we take cross multiplication, we get xn in bracket 3 plus sin xn minus, we solve this bracket, minus 3xn minus minus becomes plus cos xn plus 1 divided by 3 plus sin xn is okay, is equal to, then we multiply this xn inside the bracket, we get 3 into xn plus xn into sin xn minus 3 into xn plus cos xn plus 1 divided by 3 plus sin xn. Okay, is equal to, here 3 sin plus 3 sin xn minus 3 x sin minus. Here plus 3x n minus 3x n gets cancelled and we get is equal to x n into sin x n plus cos x n plus 1 divided by 3 plus sin x n. Okay. Then we get this is the Newton-Raphson formula for given function. Then for n is equal to 0. If we put n is equal to 0 in equation, we take it as equation 1 for n is equal to 0, we get x1 be the next approximate root. X1 is equal to x0 sin x0 plus cos x0 plus 1 divided by 3 plus sin x0. Okay, is equal to x0 will be considered as 0.6. So we put here this value 0.6 into sin 0.6 plus cos 0.6 plus 1 divided by 3 plus sin 0.6. Okay. So here after this calculation we get x1 is equal to we get value of x1 is equal to 0.6071. Here note that the angle theta value of angle theta must be taken radian. Okay, we get x1 will be 0.6071. then we find the next iteration or the next approximate root. Okay, so if we put n is equal to 1 in equation number 1, then we get x2 is equal to x1 sin x1 plus cos x1 plus 1 divided by 3 plus sin x1 is equal to x1 we put here 0.6071. okay, then we get 0.6071 into sin of 0.6071. okay, plus cos of 0.6071 plus 1 divided by 3 plus sin 0.6071. okay, then it's equal to after this calculation again we take value will be 0.6071. again we get x2 will be same as x1. So here we get x1 and x2, these two approximation, successive approximation are same up to 4 decimal points. So this is the approximate root of the given equation by Newton-Raphson method. So we get here x1 and x2, these successive approximations are same up to 4 decimal digits. So we take, so x is equal to 0.6071 is approximate root of given equation by Newton-Raphson formula. Okay, so in this way we can find the approximate root by using Newton-Raphson formula. Okay, thank you.